Hi everyone, welcome back to Chillin With Chilli Sid, and I'm going to do a sauce review. Yes, I put out a post a little while ago about how excited I was to get some of these Screaming Chimp sauces. Oh my god, you know what, you will not believe it. These arrived, yeah, and I thought I'd get two sent to me by Niall. No, not two, not four, six. Yes, you heard, six of these, yeah. So because six is too much to do in a sauce review, I'm going to do three at a time. So I've chosen three that I'm going to do. So I've got the original hot sauce, the Screamer, that sounds good, and the mango and papaya, because I thought a fruity one with two others. So Screaming Chimp. Now I put out this on Instagram and everybody seems to like the logo and what isn't there to like, because check this out, I love it, I absolutely love it. That chimp's got better teeth than I have. So that Screamer, really nice size bottle there. So let me just see which one I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to chase the original hot sauce first. It's a 100ml bottle, square bottle, nice square bottle, easy to hold. Not too thick, can you hear it? Not too thin either. It's a nice sort of, well, it's nice consistency. The original hot sauce, this is a three chilies hot sauce, and it says, let me just have a quick look. Here we go. This is the sauce which launched the Screaming Chimp Chili Sauce Company, originally created for my sister for a man versus food chicken wing eating competition. Right, with UK grown Fatale Habanero, RG lemons, Narca chilies. This sauce is great with cheeses. Now you're talking. You know I like cheeses, yeah? This is going to be great with cheeses. Barbecues, fish and vegetarian dishes. All kinds of chicken wings. It's sauce come with anything. So you can add it with anything, yeah? And if it says cheeses on a cheese board, that's yum for me all straight away. Right, ingredients. Ingredients are tomatoes, 60% tomatoes, tomato juice, acidity regulator, which is your citric acid, your orange juice, your onion, lemon juice, white wine vinegar, demerara sugar, chilies, which are 3.4%, garlic and chipotle. Now the chilies in here aren't as much. Tomato is the main ingredient, chilies are 3.4%. When I was talking to Niall, he mentioned to me that his sauces went on the heat side, the extreme, they're more flavor. So there are two types of sauces. When you're looking at hot sauces or chili sauces, anything to do with chilies, hot sauces, there's two types. You've got flavorsome sauces, which are actually divine. I've come across quite a few flavorsome sauces, and I'll tell you what, they blow your socks away. They are jam-packed with flavor. And then you've got the heat sauces, where they go slightly up, yeah, and to the very extreme. Like anything, you've got the mild right up to the hot. Now, enough said, I'm just going to crack on with these bottles, yeah? So let's have a quick look. Let's show you this one. This one is original hot sauce. This is this first one. I'm assuming it's the first one, original hot sauce. Now check this out. We looked at the logo, Screaming Chimp, love him. And then look at the ingredients in there. Yum, yum, yum. Have seeds in there. You can see you've got two types of seeds, the tomato seeds, the chili seeds. And if you look at the pore and the neck, it's not too thick, not too thin. Just a nice consistency, isn't that? Nice consistency there. Right, let's just crack into it. Okay. I love the size bottles, there's nice square ones. Okay, obviously, as you can imagine, heavily tomatoey. I can smell the tomatoes. Now, there is a heat to it. Tomatoes, I can smell this acidic. Now, he didn't have vinegar in there. We had citric acid and you had orange juice in there, lemon juice. There was vinegar. Okay, main things I can smell are your tomatoes or the tomato puree that's gone in there. There's a little heat aroma of heat or chilies. I can detect the habanero smell because they're one of my favorite chilies, habaneros, yeah. The pod smells there. You've also got the citric. I can smell like the vinegary, but you've also got orange juice and lemon juice in there. So the citric notes coming in. So what? I'm just going to give it one more quick shake. And let's just do this, yeah. Now because it's not a thick one, I can actually do it here, because I think that will show you how nice this sauce is. There we go, look at that. Are you mouth watering yet? I am. Check it out. Nice consistency. So nice color, it's got nice consistency, it's not too bitty, has got seeds in it. Now it's not as dark has, I'd say, as a tomato ketchup or Heinz ketchup, that sort of flavour. It's on the lighter side, and maybe it's to do with the habaneros that are in there. There might be orange ones or yellow ones, so it's toned the colour down a bit. So it's not a bright red tomato-y sauce colour, but you know what? It's a different sauce, so I can smell the heat. I can actually smell the Tali chilies, did you say, in there? Yep, I can smell the habaneros came through the bottleneck. And there's the hint of the fatale coming through as well. So you can smell the pods. Nothing for it. Let's get it down my neck. Here we go. Okay. It's a nice one. Actually, I thought with that much tomatoes in there that it would be just mainly tomato paste. No, it's a nice warming one. You put it in your mouth, you can feel the heat straight away. So the heat goes through. It's not enough to give you a throat burn. Nice warming on your tongue. You've got a massive tomato infusion in there and the citric coming in, the lemons and that. This sauce has got a 3 out of 5 chili rating. Now for me, it's nice, yeah. It had a kick, it was warm, the heat has gone down now, it's not on my tongue, and the flavour was really nice. Tomatoey, oniony, and this lovely, like a fatale habanero mix. You can actually taste them, it's really, really nice. But if you don't eat chilies at all, it says it's a 3 out of 5, it might even be a 4, up to 4. For you, it's a 3 to 4 out of 5. And if you do eat chilies, I think that'd be like a 1, maybe, because this is an mega, mega, mega extreme hot sauce. It's more flavor, and it packs the punch. It has got flavor. Niall, thank you for sending this to me. Thank you very much, right? So that's that one. Love that one. Now, second one I'm going to go to is, let's stick with the red theme. Let's go Screamer. Now, check this one out. You know what? I love these chimp logos. Now, let's put it there, the Screamer. Wow, so that's really good. Here we go. Again, 100ml bottle. Sauce, so works great with barbecues, cheeses, white fish, steak, burger, stir fry, simply on pizza. Also great with lots of vegetarian or vegan dishes, and great in soups and gravy. So that's really good, isn't it? It can flavor up your gravy. Make some made from ingredients which are naturally and gluten-free, vegan friendly. This sauce has no artificial color, so we like that. Vegan friendly, natural ingredients, flavors and preservatives, all natural. So as I said, I love it. Oh my god, that was a 3 heat chili. I've gone up to a 5, so this is gonna have a kick to it. So ingredients are, again, we've got tomatoes, 60% tomatoes, tomato juice, acidity regulator, citric acid, chilies 12%, orange juice, demerara sugar, cider vinegar, onion, lemon juice, lime juice, garlic and salt. Now they are exactly similar ingredients to the first one, which is the original hot sauce, except we've gone up in our levels of chili. We've gone up to 12% on this one when we only had about 3.4%, but it does say it's 5 chilies. So if you look at the ratings of that one, 1 is a 3 and 1 is a 5, yeah? So this is going to have a bit more kick. I think I did it in the right order. Now, okay, all I can show you now is the actual body of the sauce. And again, because you've got tomatoes and things in there, you're going to have tomato seeds. It's a nice consistency. Look at that. It's not too thick, not too thin. And the pore on the neck is really good. Look, it's actually quite nice, that one. It's easy to get out of the bottle. It's like a nice sauce. Yeah? Go. Oh, the lid's got stuck. Don't you just hate it when the lid gets a boo? You're coming to help. Not sure about her today because she's having, I don't know what it is, a midlife crisis probably. So we'll see if she turns up. She doesn't, doesn't matter really. Now check this neck out. It's really nice. Nice and thick. Are you getting hungry yet, guys? Look at that. If you want to come up, pick them up on your own. So, yes. Right, straight away, your tomatoes and your reapers. Yeah, I can smell the reapers in there. So, your tomatoes, reapers have that characteristic, it's almost exotic flavour. So I can smell the exotic flavour in there. And vinegar. So your tomatoes, citric or vinegary, and your reapers. Nothing for it, you just need to go for it. Right, so are you going to sit over there? She's not being too in a sauce review mood today. You know, you have those moments. She's got a bit of a cold boil of diet might. So here we go. But this one's a little bit thicker than the previous one, but check it out. Look at that. I love it when the pour like that, so really nice. check that one out. You're all jealous. Good, it's mine. So again, quite it's a bit thicker than the first one, so I think it's a thicker consistency. You can see bits in there, seeds, bit, and lots and lots of red bits. It could be from the tomatoes, it could be from the chili. So enough said, let's put this down because we've got to enjoy this. There we go. Reaper, yeah, you can tell on that one I can detect the habaneros and the patalis. This one, the Reaper, has got an overpowering. So even if it's got the marugas in there and the nagas, the Reaper's got the main smell. You can't smell the heat, but you can smell the floral pods. So that's what I'm talking about when I say Reapers. So, tomato-y, Reaper-y, cheers, down my neck. Okay. Tomatoes and Reapers go nicely together. That's a hot one. Like, not extremely hot. It's still warm on my tongue. The whole of my mouth is warm. And I'm waiting for the heat to go away. So on this one, you've got the tomatoey taste and the citric notes coming in. It's a little bit sweet as well. And so it gives it a nice sort of flavor with the onions. So it's sweet, a little bit sweet, oniony, tomatoey, getting the picture now, and warm. Now the warmth isn't so warm that you can't eat it. You can't actually detect heat smell. It's gone onion in my tongue, a little bit down my throat, but it's not burning. It's like a lovely cozy warm. See what I'm saying? That sort of warm. So the 5 heat rating on here is right. It's 5 heat rating. Now for me, that was a cozy warm. If you do not eat chilies at all, that would be a 5 out of 5. That'd be really hot. So you need to take it easy with this one. And if you do eat chilies, I'd say it could probably be about a 2 out of 5, maybe 2 or 3 out of 5. Yeah. Again, being warm, I'm just going to quickly check to see what suggested uses were. I did read them. Okay, here we go. So you've got your fries, your burgers, your cheese, fish, steaks, pizza. Now both of these you divide on pizza, yeah, so you can have it as a pizza sauce. Any vegetarian dishes, you can add it to things. Now because this one's warmer than that one, you can probably put it in cooking. The reason why I said not to put that one in cooking is if you were doing it for the heat, you would lose that flavor, you get more tomato. This one has got the heat, so you can add it to your cooked things, your spaghetti bolognese, your meatballs, anything with a gravy. It says great goes great with gravies, bangers and mash with gravy, shepherd's pie, all of those sort of things. You can put it in, you can put it in hot pots, soups, curries, rice, lentils, all of those things, and salad things. Okay guys, what can I say? I'm about to do the fruity sauce, and guess who's joined me? Boo, say hello. Boo, come up here, say hello. Boo, come and say hello. Come and say hello. Now, Boo must like very fruity sauces because she was wandering around the garden lost, and now she's decided to join us. Okay, should we go on with this one? Shall we? Just chill. Okay. It's yellow. What can you think? What fruits do you think is going to be? Mangoes, pineapples. You're right. So this one is mango and papaya. And this one has won the Great Taste Award. So it's a 100-gram bottle. This sauce was inspired by a trip to our friends in, is it Nerja, Spain? It was on this visit that the name Screaming Chimp was born. So what year was that was born? It's great as a salad dressing in stir fries with salmon, prawns, chicken, wraps, vegetarian dishes. Great mixed with, mixed into porridge or ice cream. Now you're talking, aren't you? Porridge or ice cream. Also lovely in soups, great sauces and gravy. So it's very versatile. Being sweet, you can use it on desserts as well. So this one's a winner chimp on your dinner. I like that. No artificial colors, flavorings, preservatives or allergens. Gluten-free, suitable for vegetarians and vegans. And I think if I miss that, that's more or less the same for all of these other sauces. And this one, just very quickly show you, has won the Great Taste Award. So there is the award in 2007. Screaming Chimp won that award. Okay, so well done for that. Now ingredients, not tomatoes, surprise. We've got mango, 62%, 17% papayas and pineapple. You've got demerara sugar, white wine vinegar, onion, red bell peppers, chili and lemon juice. So the chilies, they haven't said what chilies, it's 3%. And I'm just thinking of if there's any, okay, they might just be general chilies, just for the heat. I think it's more about the fruity flavour. Now, just If I just show you that as it's pouring, look at that thickness. Now that is a little bit thicker than the other sauces. It's not as gloopy as earlier, but check it out. Check out the body of that sauce. Look at that. Yummy, yummy. So you can see that I'm going to love this one. Divine colour. It's fruity. It's got flecks in it. Red fleck. Bit of cat fluff on the bottle. Let's remove that. Right. Let's go for it. Bit of a breezy day today. Well, you've got to do your sauce reviews, haven't you? You can't just say it's a breezy day. I'm not going to do it. You just got to get on with it, don't you, really? Okay, here we go. That is mangoes. Mangoes, mangoes, mangoes. And I love mangoes. Oh God, mangoes. Now anything else, I know it's got papaya in it and it's got pineapple in it, but you know what, the only thing I can smell, mangoes. And I'm just going to show you this. I don't know if you can see it because it's quite deep down. I don't want to pour it all over the camera. Check that well out. Oh, there you go. See, here we go. Come on. Whoa, yummy, yummy, yummy. What was it? Chimp on my dinner. So what did I say? Winner, winner, chimp on your dinner. So this is the chimp on my dinner. Check that out. Now that is divine. Loving it. Now, nothing changed. Mangoes. Not at all. Mangoes. Even though it's got red flecks in it. Mangoes. Here we go. Let's put that down. Get it down my neck. Okay, what do you think I could taste? Yes, you're right, mangoes in there. It's sweet, obviously. Mangoes is tart, and mangoes fruit as fruit is tart and sweet, so you've got the mango tartness and the sweetness. You can detect a bit of pineapple in there. Papaya, I can't detect the papaya in there. It's probably in, but the flavour of it isn't. It's 17% papaya, but I can't actually detect the papaya. But mangoes and the pineapple and the sugar and the chilies that are in there, you know what? I can't detect them at all. Now, this is a 2 chili rating on here. Maybe it's because I've done the 2 previous sauces that my buds are kind of gone, but it is sweet. Sticky, sweet, nice. And 2 chili rating here. I'm just trying to think, the chilies that are in there are only 3%, and they might not be enough to make it that hot. I think it's just a little flavor enhancer in there. So because my tongue's probably warm from those two, hence maybe I can't detect it. But you know what, I love a mango sauce. This one's really, really nice. It's sweet, tangy, sticky. What's there not to like on this one? And because you've got the low pH, you can actually marinate with these if you wanted to add it to your marinades, and either of those as well, because they've got the lemon juice, orange juice and the vinegar and the tomatoes. So if you wanted to marinate with these, you could. Now imagine a nice bit of meat that you've put on the barbie and you've got mango pineapple marinade on it, like a glaze. That would be really nice, wouldn't it? It's a beautiful color. It's a very lovely sort of summery color, and as recommended, you can put it on any salads, fresh salads, anything that's salad-y, dips, drizzling it on things, you know, drizzling it on your falafels or falafels, whatever you call them. Oh my God, because it's a sweet one, so because it's sweet, ice creams, waffles, pancakes, all those things, you can add a bit of this to, you can add it to your yogurts, and you know what, the list is endless. But 2 chili rating. For me, it was sweet, sticky, and I didn't notice the heat, mainly because of the review of those, I think. If you don't eat chilies at all, I think that 2 would be a 2, maybe more, but not this one. No, actually, it would be a 2. If you eat chilies, it'll be nothing. It's more like a fruity twist, a heavy fruity twist, really. Now, Niall, thank you. I'm going to do this because it looks good. Thank you for sending me these Screaming Chimp sauces. Everybody out there, should you want to order any of these sauces, because they have more flavor than heat, so anyone can have them, you know what to do, don't you? Order, like, subscribe, stick loads of comments in there, and if there's any comments I can't answer, Niall will. Thank you very much for sending me these, Niall. Thank you for watching, and guys, don't fear the reaper, okay?